Hey guys, today I'm going to be showing you a different way to make biochar as well as different ways to inoculate it that I didn't get to show you in that first video. If you didn't get a chance to see that video, I'll be sure to put a link up here to that, and let's get right into it. Keep in mind that as you're digging the pit, you're going to take the extra dirt and just pile it up all the way around in a circle. This is going to create a nice windbreak as well as make the pit even deeper. Now you're going to want to start collecting your biomass or materials. I like to have small pieces, medium-sized pieces, and then the larger pieces. Here you can see we have hay, sunflower stems, and branches. So I got all this extra wood that I've been collecting. It's just a bunch of scrap wood. This is not treated, okay? It's untreated wood. You wanna make sure you're not using treated wood. Just a bunch of, you could say heat treated, which that's fine. Like even pallet wood's fine if it has the heat treated stamp on it. All right, so I'm gonna show you how you can take a board like this and make it into smaller pieces. So just set it up onto something hard like this. Take your axe, make sure your hand is far away. And then you're gonna hit the furthest edge right here, like that. And this last one, just move your hand out of the way. So now we're gonna take our kindling right here, the smallest, finest, easiest that'll burn. We're gonna place that at the bottom like that. And then we're gonna put our sunflower stems right on top of there. And I'm also gonna take some of my smaller pieces and put those here as well. Once that starts getting hot, we can go ahead and start dropping them in. So we're starting with our smallest pieces first, and then we'll build up. We're gonna keep piling in our pieces just like this. We're gonna bury that flame. We're trying to bury the flame as quick as possible. You can put some real dry small stuff on top to help with the smoking, to kind of get that fire, the red flame again.
Notice how quickly the smoke calms down and the flame reignites and gets hot really quick once I add the kindling on top, those smaller pieces. This is what you want to get good end results. This section here is just going to be a recap of what we've kind of already gone over using branches instead of scrap wood.
Some other examples of materials that you could use are giant reed or bamboo that's been dried out. You don't want a lot of air space in between branches. That's why we're using a tamper here to kind of get things pushed down further into the pit. Rusty, what do you think about this, huh?
Look at him, he's so cute.
Bye-bye.
If the majority of your material is already becoming embers, it's a good idea to move the larger stuff to the side. So what I'm doing here is I'm burying all the embers lightly with about an inch of soil. What this is going to do is prevent the wood from turning into ash while at the same time allowing any wood pieces that are not fully cooked to cook all the way through. Here are the pieces that we pulled aside earlier, and all we're gonna do is pull them back into the pit and allow them to cook all the way through before we extinguish them.
So we're just raking off this dirt on top. If y'all know of a more effective way to do this, be sure to drop it in the comment section. Let me know. But I'm just gonna use this. It's kind of like a hoe tool, but with teeth on it to break up and pull things up. Look at that. You hear the sound? That is some good biochar right there. So we're gonna come in. We're gonna start harvesting this. I've got these buckets here. You can wear gloves. I'm one of those guys that doesn't wear gloves very often, which a lot of you already know. If you get a little bit of dirt with the biochar, cool, no problem. Just gonna be more organic matter and maybe even some microbes. Very pretty, look at that. Just set this down in here like that. Take a scoop of the dirt and the biochar, toss it on this. Like this stuff here, some of this is like clay, like a little bit of clay. That's actually good. It's really nice stuff to have in your soil because it helps retain moisture. So I'm not worried about that. And I'm just gonna take this bucket, I'm gonna dump that in here. Hey son, can you cook me a marshmallow?
Yeah.
All right, that's good. Son, that's good. You're gonna burn it. That's good.
Okay, fine.
Yeah, I'm definitely not going to eat that. Oh, disgusting.
No, that's a good marshmallow. Fire.
This is by far my favorite method when it comes to extinguishing the embers. It's super easy to do, it's clean, it doesn't require a lot of work, and it's effective. And if you do a little quick research, you'll find that it's actually one of the most recommended methods for putting out the embers. Many of you already know that when it comes to pulverizing biochar, I like to use a canvas cloth to place the biochar on top of and crush it. This helps to keep everything in place where I'm not losing material and makes it easy to take it and dump it into my container that I'm using. I like to take the canvas cloth and fling off the remaining pieces of biochar into my chicken run or into the garden. However, that day the cloth was very wet and made a big mess, and yeah, about that. These are the guys that do all the work for us when it comes to making amazing, rich, what they call black gold. So these are the heroes here that do all the work. All right, one of the first things I'm going to show you, another way you can inoculate your biochar other than using a liquid fertilizer is you can put it into your vermicompost system. So this is all stuff that I'm going to be harvesting out, and that you can mix it in on the side that needs to be harvested, or you can come over here on your side that you just fed your composting worm. What I'm going to do is move this back, and I'm going to dump some of this on top of the scraps that I've fed them recently, just like this. The worms are going to come, and they'll bring this down, they'll mix it in for me, and when this is finished compost, or when that's just worm castings in here, all this stuff will be fully inoculated. Alright, so we're just going to bring our leaves back over here, and then we're going to cover it. So you might be wondering, why would I ever even make this stuff? What's the point? Well, the point is to create soil, a healthy soil. I mean, this soil has had, you know, different treatments of biochar, compost. This soil has been fed year after year. We've put in inoculated biochar into our beds, whether it's in our compost, the chicken manure, in the vermicompost system. But this is what it's all about. And see all this out here? It's thriving because we feed our soil year after year. Oh yeah, right there. Look at that little guy. Oh yeah. Next method for inoculating your biochar is gonna be tossing it down underneath your chicken roosting bars. This is a super easy way to inoculate biochar. This biochar, remember, is already kind of moist. That's what we want, because that's going to kickstart the process of the organisms, encouraging the microorganisms to come in and inhabit the pores and everything in this biochar. So it's already kind of nice, and it's got a nice dampness. It's not soaking wet, it's just damp. What's cool about this is not only is it going to, is this going to inoculate our biochar, it's also going to neutralize the ammonia, the smell that comes from the manure. All right, so this little pile here, it's probably about 2 feet deep. This is all the chicken bedding that's coming out of my chicken coop. And I wanted to show you, like, see, there's even some biochar right here inside of it, okay? From when I've thrown it into their bedding before. And I mean, just look at how rich this stuff is. It's absolutely amazing. So yeah, here's some more, look. This one wasn't crushed as well. This is before I did a lot of the pulverizing, but still works the same way. It's just not gonna go as far. It's not gonna have as much surface area. But I mean, guys, this stuff right here, all thanks to these guys over here. So if you have a pile of your chicken bedding that you've been just piling for years, you can simply take that biochar that you've created, okay? And you can just sprinkle it into that pile, and that's gonna inoculate that that biochar, okay? I remember the first time I ever saw my chickens eat biochar was when I was making biochar and there was some left over in the pit, and I found them eating it and was like, what do they know that I don't know? And so I did a little research and found that it's actually good for them. Hey, so I'm in my compost area. I'm harvesting out what remains over here so that I can start throwing my pile here. I wanted you to see some of this finished, look at this, some of this finished compost here. And it's got pieces of biochar all through it. These will all be pieces all inside here. It's super rich. I mean, look at that, it's amazing. This is why we do it. Some biochar right there. So really good stuff. So I'm just taking that and I'm harvesting it in this bucket here. And then we're gonna flip the pile over here. I'll show you how we add the biochar into the compost. During this process, it's very important to make sure that the material is damp. This pile that I'm turning here happened to be just right, so I'm not adding any moisture to it, but you may wanna keep a hose nearby when you see dry spots so you can spray it. Now I'm gonna go through and I'm gonna sprinkle this just like this, right on top. And then we're gonna add another layer. All right, now we're gonna take our biochar and we're gonna sprinkle the top again. So we're basically just doing layers, thin layers of biochar. And then we're gonna cover it with compost to inoculate it. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you learned today how easy it is to inoculate your biochar. Not only how to inoculate it, but how to make it and create a small pit like this. And hey, if you enjoyed it, as always, give it a thumbs up, and we're always happy to hear from you in the comment section. God bless y'all, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.